Now we're going to illustrate how matrix multiplication can be used to transform an object on the coordinate plane. For example, if we take a look at this red triangle on the coordinate plane, we can organize the coordinates of the vertices as a 3x2 matrix seen here, where each row represents a vertex. The point negative 2, 3 is the first row, the point negative 4, negative 2 is the second row, and the point 5, 0 is the third row. So we're going to find the product of matrix A and matrix B, plot the points again on the coordinate plane, and see how it transforms the triangle. So for matrix A times matrix B, we'll have this 3x2 matrix times this 2x2 matrix. Remember, the first step is to make sure this product is defined, meaning we can only perform this multiplication when the number of columns in the first matrix is equal to the number of rows in the second matrix. So here we have a 3x2 matrix, and here we have a 2x2 matrix. So because these two values are the same, this means the product is defined. If these weren't the same, we could not perform this multiplication. The product would be undefined. And if we set it up this way, the number of rows in the first matrix and the number of columns in the second matrix give us the dimensions of the product. So this product will be a 3x2 matrix. And now to find this product, we'll be multiplying rows in the first matrix and columns in the second matrix. To know which row and column to use, we have to know the location of each element in this 3x2 matrix. So if we go across the first row, element A sub 1 comma 1, we're going to multiply row 1 in the first matrix by column 1 in the second matrix. We always use rows from the first matrix and columns from the second matrix. And to multiply the row and the column, we'll find the product of the first elements and second elements, and then find that sum. So A sub 1 comma 1 is going to be equal to negative 2 times 0, which is 0, plus 3 times negative 1, which is negative 3. Next we'll find the element in row 1, column 2. So now we'll use row 1 from the first matrix and column 2 from the second matrix. So we would have negative 2 times 1, that's negative 2, plus 3 times 0, so our element is negative 2. Now let's go to the second row. We'll find the element in row 2, column 1. Now we'll use row 2 from the first matrix and column 1 from the second matrix. So we would have negative 4 times 0, which is 0, plus negative 2 times negative 1, which is positive 2. Next we'll find the element in row 2, column 2. So we'll use row 2 from the first matrix and column 2 from the second matrix, which means we would have negative 4 times 1, that's negative 4, plus negative 2 times 0, so that's negative 4. And now for the third row, we'd have a sub 3 comma 1 for the element in row 3, column 1. So now we'll use row 3 in the first matrix and column 1 from the second matrix. So we would have negative 5 times 0, that's 0, plus 0 times negative 1, which is also 0, so our element is 0. And then finally, for the element in row 3, column 2, we'll use row 3 from the first matrix and column 2 from the second matrix. So we would have 5 times 1, that's 5, plus 0 times 0, so the element would be 5. So now what we're going to do is plot these new points on the coordinate plane and see how it transforms the red triangle. So the coordinates of the new vertices will be negative 3, negative 2, 2, negative 4, and 0, 5. This graph is a little busy, but the red triangle is the original triangle, and the blue triangle is the transformed triangle. So notice how the transformation is a rotation counterclockwise of 90 degrees. So by multiplying by matrix B, the product gave us the coordinates of a triangle that's rotated 90 degrees counterclockwise. So one application of matrix multiplication is to perform transformations on the coordinate plane. And there are a lot of different matrices that we can multiply by to perform a variety of transformations. So we'll finish by showing a list of several of these. If we were to multiply by any of these three matrices, it would perform the following rotations. And if we multiplied by any of these four matrices, it would perform the following reflections. Okay, hope you found this explanation helpful.